So you get to decide, I want this so bad that I'm going to put my best foot forward.
You want to set plans and make your plans happen. You don't just think about the average and shepherd's team and fight. There are a lot of photographers that think that, all the picture found, feet, this serve the pen. Once it doesn't serve the purpose, chairman, it's not that
easy. Utilizing the beholder's eyes. And I believe that for what I have now, I am willing to develop and grow. But what I have now, it's marketable and I want to sell it. And you are just opening up yourself to get work, get more experience, and be better than you were yesterday. That's all that matters.
They have that expectation of you and they recommend you to someone else. You need to know that you have to maintain that standard you've set with them. Because the most embarrassing thing is to recommend someone and then it comes back to you that I thought this person is as good as you.
How much do you want to charge for it? Like, so, what's the price? And then people come and be like, give me the price before I tell you. How? Like, it's not possible. Do you understand? So,
somebody gave me some wire. I think it's also tied to this. I don't know what it is, but it's a bad attitude. Just clean the image. I'm not saying that it has to be perfect. Because if you're shooting portraits, it's different because you're dealing with a smaller number of pictures. Like a shooting event, you know, 500, 300, lots of pictures. So, you might want to see, oh, at an event photographer, you don't have time, you have a lot of images to edit. That's granted. But it doesn't mean that you should not care for the images, or it doesn't mean that you just watch through the images and just need to care for every image.
Stay updated, but don't be. So they have to use the latest gear. I know people, look, they have the latest gear, they have the best lighting equipment. My child, when they show you their picture, be like, hey, what is all this?
No, but it helps, trust me. Being in touch with nature, let the wind in, let the light in. Go plant. Now go in purpose.
I'm going to go.
No, it's very important because that connection with nature is what resets your brain.
It's not about how much gear you have, but sometimes using a little bit of practical thoughts in filmmaking, we call something practical light. Sometimes just adding a little bit of, maybe it could be your phone touch, adding a little bit of your phone touch to a scene, just to add to the more effects and more, it changes the whole dynamics of that scene and it sends a new message.
Yeah, so I had to compromise. And I would divide almost every weekend we would get a gig or something, we could save up money. But that's why I even while I was looking, I said, think about it, not about now. And that's the answer. This is a dangerous African, I'm sorry to say that, but African mentality, they think about now. They want the money now, they want everything now. Everything now. They don't think about the future. Everything.
Bill. That part of you to be able to take control of the space when you are in it. I mean, I just said that that's where concentrating on a certain niche for now, which is not ultimately what you want to do, but that one helps you build that confidence to be able to do something.
We are not in operation for people not to buy their home yet, but we are in operation to solve a problem which exists as a result of some project that you have to partake or do within an extra year. That is why you count on us.